Hey everyone, Vinayak here. I've had the older version of the Galaxy Buds, which I had reviewed earlier. Today, I have with me the newer iteration, the Galaxy Buds Plus. So let's check them out. The older Galaxy Buds were a good pair of earbuds, and for the price point, they had a lot of features which even the pricier models didn't have at that time. The new Galaxy Buds released alongside with the S20 series of flagship phones are Samsung's new flagship earbuds. Here's the packaging. The box has the Buds Plus branding on it with the image of the device adorning the front. The back has the features, 11 hours of playback time, this I've got to see. And it's got a new dual driver setup which is supposed to improve the sound. 3 microphones for better call quality. And the features not available on most earbuds, wireless charging. Price on the box is ₹13,999, but it's being sold for 11K at present. As you all know, I've picked up the Galaxy S20 Plus, which enabled purchasing the Galaxy Buds Plus at ₹1,999, the actual price being 11K. This is a great offer and I picked it up. I purchased it off the Samsung store online, as the offer price would only work on their site. Let's open up the box and check out what's inside. We are first greeted by the Galaxy Buds Plus with their charging case. I have the black variant, it's quite glossy. Next, we have a small white box which contains the USB-C charging cable, an extra wingtips and also earbuds to find the correct fit for your ears. Now back to the buds. Getting the protective cover off, the case is completely accessible. And ever since Samsung purchased Harman, they have access to Harman's entire catalog of audio patents and their other brands such as JBL, B&O and AKG. All buds provided with their phones now have the AKG tune branding on them, and the Galaxy Buds Plus are no different. The case has a 270mAh battery which charges the buds whenever they are docked within. This case is really glossy and is a fingerprint magnet. A USB port allows charging the case, and opening up the top lid, here we have the buds within. The buds are magnetically held within the case, which is similar to how they were on the older version. This time though, the case hinge seems to be more sturdy. A LED displays the battery level, which is indicated by the color green, indicating it is fully charged. Yellow when the charge is between 30 and 60% and red when the battery goes below 30%. It also flashes red when the case battery is really low. Looks wise, the buds look quite identical to their older cousins. They are quite small and don't stick out much from your ear, which is how I generally like my earbuds to be. The weight is quite less, almost to the point we almost don't feel them in the ear. So let's pair the buds with the phone. As I have the Galaxy S20 Plus by Samsung, we get this neat little animation with the option to connect to the buds with one click. This would open up the Galaxy Wearable app, and once linked, you're ready to use the buds. The Galaxy Wearable app is available for other phones also, and also on iOS, which makes these buds work with almost all devices. They do sit in your ears quite snug. These are not noise-cancelling earbuds, but they do have a good seal in your ears, which does block out the surrounding sounds, and in other words, have passive noise cancellation. But if you want to be able to hear your surroundings, especially when walking on the streets, I mean, sound is great. It's a great feature available on the app. It allows varying degrees of sound input, which is done by the external microphones on the device, allowing you to hear more or less of the ambient sound. Do note, if you have your music up all the way, ambient sound settings won't help. Until unless you pause the audio, you will not be able to hear anything outside in your surroundings. Supporting Bluetooth 5.0, the range is quite good. The buds can work independent of each other. Even if you remove one of them from the ear, the other continues to play. Battery life is up to 11 hours, which is phenomenal, and with the case to charge them provides one more full charge, and we have 22 hours of battery life. I don't use my earbuds for that long, so can't test their claim, but for normal use for an hour or two, my buds were always ready to go for at least a week before I needed to charge the case. The buds still had almost full power. The battery levels are displayed on the Galaxy Wearable app for each individual bud and also the case. 3 minutes of charge in the case gives you 1 hour of playback time, and 10 minutes equates to 3 hours of playback, which is great if you need to juice up your buds fast. You can also use wireless power share feature on your Galaxy phone to quickly charge them up. It also supports charging, so use any wireless charger and you will be able to wirelessly charge the buds up. In case you misplace the buds, you can use the Find My Earbuds option to play a chirping sound on them, which helps in finding it. Okay, now for the audio quality, what you guys really want to know. Being AKG tuned, the sound quality is great. I mostly use it in the dynamic mode setting via the app. The treble is quite good and the volume goes up pretty high. But the immersion is just not present. True that the sound stage is left neutral as most studio tuned devices, but I would have liked more immersion. Bass is neutral, not heavy, and not bad either. The dual driver setup does help with mid-range sounds, and they are great with vocals and instruments, playing out really clean. The Jabra 65Ts don't go as loud, but the immersion is also different. If you like the source audio mostly untouched, the Galaxy Buds Plus will not disappoint. Calls on the buds are still not that great. This is how they sound.
So this is basically the quality of the audio from the Galaxy Buds Plus. It sounds pretty good when the environment is not that noisy. So this is how the quality is going to sound. Let's check out the Jabras to know more. And this is how the audio is going to sound from the Jabra 65Ts. I have a feeling the four microphones on the Jabras are going to make it sound much better, but let's check it out.
The controls on the device are touch responsive. So double tap on the right earbud for the next song, double tap on the left earbud to play the previous song or accept a call. It can be done on both. Tap once on any to pause, tap and hold to activate your smart assistant. You can change the option to whatever you would like on the app, such as activate ambient sound, etc. Both buds will mirror the same functionality. You can't set each one to have a different function, but you can also enable the volume control feature in the Galaxy Wearable app under Labs. This allows to double tap the edge of the buds for volume up and volume down. The touch controls are a love-hate relationship. I honestly don't like the touch controls, as when you're trying to adjust the buds in your ears, you end up tapping the controls by mistake. I like the physical buttons on my Jabra 65Ts more than these. We do have the option to disable touch controls, as we mostly have our phones within arm's reach, we can control everything from there. But if you're on a walk or on a run, the touch controls are present. Another thing I'm surprised about is the IPX2 rating, which in this day and age, most buds supporting IPX6. So small splashes, sweat is fine, but don't wear them in the rain if you don't want to damage them. With obscene choices in the market from the budget to expensive categories, Samsung has much more competition in the earbud space. USB-C charging allows me to carry only one cable, and wireless charging is also a nifty feature it has. Enabling wireless power share on my phone also can charge up the device by just placing a top on the device. If you like bass heavy songs, you may not like these buds. Make sure to try them out before purchasing. The case is also a bit slippery because of its glossy finish and can fall out of your pocket, especially when sitting down, so be very careful. At a price point of 11K, they're not cheap and do deliver on their promise in a way, but if you have a chance of getting them at ₹1999, then these will not disappoint. So that was the video. Make sure to like, subscribe, and also hit the bell icon to be notified when new videos are added. Thank you for watching, and see you all next time.